Good morning, boys and girls, ladies, gentlemen, and other. Today is May the 5th, even though it's not on my clock right now. Hope you all enjoyed the 4th of May in Star Wars fashion, hopefully in some way, shape, or form. So yesterday I had you guys do your posting of the either interactive videos or alternate projects, those slideshows. I know it's kind of mixed things, but I think we should at least see what people are doing as alternates. Today I want you to vote on your favorite one, as you know we always do. So that should be, but that is not in there. All right, so I'm going to put that link in there. Okay, now the link is in there, even though you guys should know how to find it. Anyway, you've already joined it. So that's the first thing. Put your comment in there. That's an English grade for today. Next, we're going to get into, and actually we'll talk about that today at 1 o'clock. That'll be part of the critique during the Google Meet if you wanted to come for extra credit. All right, got to get that extra credit. So today we're going to get into some game design, a little bit more, I guess, a little more so than we have been doing up to this point. We've been doing a lot of storytelling. I think a lot of you are waiting for some game design. And what we're going to use is called Scratch. This is a, as you can see in the URL, an MIT project. Somebody developed this. So pretty cool in what we have here. What we can do is I made a Pong game. This is one of the basic ones that they have here. And let's see, if I move my cursor, oh, I ended the game because I let the DVC logo crash into the line. So let's see if I, and we can make this bigger. Ah, all right, so the program, actually if I refresh it maybe, let's see. The reason I chose this is that you can personalize the graphics. Here we go, now we're working. And it will keep a score as you're going. So I chose the background, I found the logo, and then I found the French fries here on the bottom, and the score on the top keeps going up until it goes to the red line, and then the game ends. So there's probably more we can do with that, but I think that's kind of a good start, you know, trying to do maybe cross this across 2 days and give you guys some time to work on that and get your graphics together and get the programming. So that is the goal for the class objective. So that's the finished one. You can kind of play around with that. And what I'm giving you next is a link, which I think, come on mouse, should take you directly to this tutorial. All right, so it's gonna.
You can use Scratch to make a Pong game.
I'm gonna advance through. So it goes step by step here. So it's, if it says add a background here, you're going to do it over here on yours. So you can choose one of these pre-made ones in this case, or you can, if you hover over, you go up to upload backdrop, then you can bring in your own picture. So that's what I did. So as you do each phase, and actually let's just say for this, it does, I think it gives you, I thought it gave you a confirmation that you did it correctly, but let's see if I went too fast. Oh, so there we go. So add the backdrop, it's on the stage, all right? Maybe as you get to more of the programming. So then we go to a sprite, you would add another one, or you can upload one. Amon, all right? So it's gonna keep going here. So now we have that into there. And now you can see when you press the play button, we didn't do anything here yet. So you're going to have all these blocks here, which I guess that's what I didn't do. I didn't go through and look at these. So they're all color-coded depending on what they do. So this one's orange. Start with that one. So do one clicked, be our first part. And then we're going to go to a blue, point in a direction. Where is it? Point in direction. Here we go. That's our next block, and we want that to be 45. So we're going to do that. And then we're going to go control again forever, and then move 16 steps and if on edge bounce. So sometimes, as you can see, maybe it is a little hard, there it is, to find the blocks that they have. And you can modify this if you want to see, but now let's test this out. All right, so there he is. He's bouncing around. We did that. That's programming. All right, we want to stop it. We press that, and you can look at these units in here. You can show these things also. So if you wanted to make him smaller, you could type in 50. So that did make it smaller. We could change his direction. So you do have control over this. This is your preview window. And that's the process here, right? So then you're just going to go through and, you know, watch each thing that they're doing on here. And when you get to the end, you can share it. I found a little trick with that is that I couldn't publish it at first, but you may have to, I think you have to, when you create your account, you have to activate it. So once you do that, then you would go to your game and there'll be a section where it says shared. Oh, here we go. So it's already shared. So I just do copy link is what we're going to be looking for. All right. So this would be the link that you would share to show me that you have your stuff in there. All right. So if you can get through this today, that's awesome. If not, be working on it Wednesday as well. Thursday, I want to start doing a Mother's Day card. So start thinking about that. It could be animated. It could be just a still graphic, use photography, something like that. But Mother's Day is this Sunday. So we want to make sure we do something with that. All right, so that is it for today. So comment on those interactive projects or videos or the slideshows. My video is just an example, and then really this site is showing you how to do it because I'm not going to make a whole video going through the same thing of what they're doing. All right, if you find that's too challenging or you just don't like it, again, do your alternate project for the day. It should represent about 30 minutes of time, so you know that's all subjective with your grade there. Make sure you're trying to put some time in there, and that goes into the slideshow at the end of the week. Try to get in the habit, if you guys do have questions, make them either class comments. I am still checking those in the spreadsheet as well, but they pop up a little quicker in the classroom, so if it's something urgent, you can put them as a class comment or a private comment. Alright, hope you guys are having a good day. It's supposed to be nice out, so enjoy, you know, get a little time in and then get outside. See you at 1 o'clock maybe. Bye.